Rasa Vrindavanam Vande Krishna Rasa Prabhum Tata Chanavata Chaitanya Lila Vishta Kalino Dvau Nityananda Prabhja Karunare Nubushito Vyakta Chano Burachincho Vavande Vyasa Rupino Shri Guru Gaur Gandharva Govindas Chaganaisa Jayanti Patakas Chacha Sarvesham Guru Naitino. So we are continuing with our reading of Sri Chaitanya-charitamrita. I was away in London for the last week, and now we're back in Hungary. The Sri Saraswati Sridhar Govinda Sena Kunja. We're continuing with our hearing of Sri Chaitanya-charitamrita, this extraordinarily wonderful scripture. So we are still in the first chapter of the Madhya Lila, and I'm going to pick up from verse 88. And, you know, as we were mentioning previously, Kaviraj Goswami, he's genuinely feeling that he may depart from this world at any time, and he's in the last years of his life. And so he's, you know, thinking that he may not complete this work before he departs. Then he's first giving a summary of everything he wants to say, you know, before he says it. So you just go back a little bit. Uddhava, we've been talking about Uddhava, right? Yesterday we were discussing Uddhava also. So this is one of the, you know, two focal points in Mahaprabhu's Leela and Jagannath Puri, in terms of them when he's entering those later years of exploring the mood of Radharani. And there are two principal moments, moods that he is exploring. One is Radharani meeting Krishna at Kurukshetra, right, after so many years of separation. And then another is when Krishna sends Uddhava to Vrindavan to give some comfort to the residents of Vrindavan. And at that time, Radharani, she comes across this bumblebee, right, that she takes as a messenger of Krishna. And she speaks this, you know, type of divine madness, you know, to this bumblebee. So this is being mentioned here. I'm going to go back to verse 87. Narikanma joiche unavadashane utkorna pralap doiche prabharachi dine. Just as Srimati Radharani talked inconsistently with a bumblebee in the presence of Uddhava, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his ecstasy talked crazily and inconsistently day and night. So these two moments, right, they represent the acme, the height of divine separation. Dadashvatsa she shaiche goailo, e matashe shlila chividane koilo. The last 12 years of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu were passed in this transcendental madness. Thus he executed his final pastimes in three ways. Sanyas kori chabish vatsa koila jeje karma ananta pata kejani bemarma. For the 24 years after Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted the renounced order, whatever pastimes he executed were unlimited and unfathomable. Who can understand the purport of such pastimes? So Mahaprabhu's Leela in this world is divided in different ways, right? The first 24 years is his Nadia Leela, living as a householder in Navadvip. And then the second 24 years, you know, he entered the sannyas order. And then the first 12 of those, he is engaging with the public. And then the final 12, he's withdrawing, right? For his own tasting matter, as our Gurudev expressed. Adeshkarite kori digdarashan mukya mukya lila kori sucha ganan.
Just to indicate those pastimes, I am presenting a general survey of the chief pastimes in the form of a synopsis.
Patam sucha babu sanyaskaran sanyaskari chalila prabhu shivindavan.
This is the first synopsis. After accepting the sannyas order, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu proceeded toward Vrindavan.
Premete vivalbhaya nahi kosmadan nanadesha dindin korila brahman.
When proceeding toward Vrindavan, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was overwhelmed with ecstatic love for Krishna, and he lost all remembrance of the external world. In this way, he traveled continuously for 3 days in Naradesh, the country where the Ganges River does not flow.
Nityananda Prabhu Mahaprabhu Balaya Ganga Tire Loya Aila Jamuna Boliya.
First of all, Lord Nityananda bewildered Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by bringing him along the banks of the Ganges, saying that it was the river Jamuna.
Shantipure Acharya Grihe Agaman Pratambika Koilo Taharache Sankirtan.
After 3 days, Mahaprabhu came to the home of Advaita Acharya at Shantipur and accepted alms there. This was his first acceptance of alms. At night, he performed congregational chanting there. So all of this we'll hear in more detail in later chapters, right? But here there's just a synopsis being given.
Mata bhakta gane taha korilo milan sarva samadhan kori koilo niladri gaman.
At the house of Advaita Prabhu, he met his mother as well as all the devotees from Mayapur. He adjusted everything and then went to Jagannath Puri.
Bhatte nana lila ras deva darashan Madhapodir Kata Gopal Stapan.
On the way to where Jagannath Puri, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu performed many other pastimes. He visited various temples and heard the story about Madhavendra Puri and the installation of Gopal. And there will be a whole chapter on this later.
Hirachari Katta Shakshi Gopal Vivaran Nityananda Koila Prabhu Danda Banjan.
From Nityananda Prabhu, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard the story of Kshira Chora Gopinath and of the witness Gopal. Then Nityananda Prabhu broke the sannyas rod belonging to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Kuda hoya ekta gela Jagannath dekhite dekhiya marchita hoya purila bhumite.
After his sannyas rod was broken by Nityananda Prabhu, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu apparently became very angry and left his company to travel alone to the Jagannath temple. When Mahaprabhu entered the Jagannath temple and saw Lord Jagannath, he immediately lost his senses and fell to the floor. So this is all actually Leela, right? And part of it, of course, who am I to speculate on what all the points are, but one of the points of this Leela, right, because Mahaprabhu, he becomes angry with Nityananda, because he broke his sannyas, chidanda, staff. But one of the points there is that then Mahaprabhu says, I'm going alone. He says, I'm not traveling with you guys. So either I go ahead, or I go after you, you decide, but we're not going together. So it's okay, you go ahead of us. So he arrives alone. And what does that mean? That means that gives a chance for Sarvabhauma, right? And Mahaprabhu alone is a liability to himself, right? Because he gets in so much ecstasy. And so he's in this temple, and the guards or the priests in the temple, they don't appreciate his ecstasy. He's a madman, and they want to beat him. But Sarvabhauma comes, right, and he can recognize, oh, this isn't an ordinary person. He's showing divine symptoms, actually. So then, this is all setting the stage. capturing the heart of Sarvabhauma.
Sarvabhauma loya gela pan bhavan jitya prahade brahma hoilo chaitan.
After Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw Lord Jagannath in the temple and fell down unconscious, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya took him to his home. The Lord remained unconscious until the afternoon when he finally regained his consciousness.
Nityananda, Jagrananda, Damodarma Kunda, Pachayasimili Sabe Pailo Ananda.
The Lord had left Nityananda's company and had gone alone to the Jagannath temple. But later Nityananda, Jagrananda, Damodarma Kunda came to see him, and after seeing him they were very pleased. So these four persons, they were accompanying Nityananda, Jagadananda, Damodara, Kunda.
Tobe sarvabhume prabhu prashan kadilo apanishwarmuti tade dekailo.
After this incident, Mahaprabhu bestowed his mercy upon Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya by showing him his original form as the Lord. So this is a whole chapter, right? This is chapter 6 of the Madhya Lila. Now we're just getting a summary.
Tobe to gorila prabhu dakingaman kormakshetra koila vasudevi mochan.
After bestowing mercy upon Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, the Lord started for southern India. When he came to Kormakshetra, he delivered a person named Vasudev.
Jira nishinge koilo nishingastavan pate pate grame grame nam pravartan.
After visiting Kormakshetra, the Lord visited the South Indian temple of Jira Nishinga and offered his prayers to Lord Nishingadev. On his way, he introduced the chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra in the village.
Along the way, introduced the Hare Krishna movement in South India.
As you do.
Godavari Tiravane Vrindavana Brahm Namananda Naisaha Tai Milan.
Once the Lord mistook the forest on the bank of the river Godavari to be Vrindavan. In that place he happened to meet Ramananda Rai. This is pivotal moment here. Madhya Lila chapter. Wait for it, people, it's coming. Ramananda Sambhad, right? Conversation between Mahaprabhu Ramananda. This is the chapter, the place.
Chimalji Padistan Koilo Dadashan Sarvacha Kodilo Krishna Nam Pracharan.
He visited the places known as Tirumal and Tirupati, where he extensively preached the chanting of the Lord's holy name.
Toveto Pashandi Gane Korilo Dalan Ahoval Nishingadi Koilo Dadashan.
After visiting the temples of Tirumal and Tirupati, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had to subdue some atheists. He then visited the temple of Ahoval Nishinga. Let me see what the Bengali says. Dealt with some atheists.
Don't worry, he didn't hurt them.
And in this Leela, he doesn't. There's no demon killing. The one moment Mahaprabhu was like getting ready for that, Nityananda stopped him. That was Jagai and Madai, right? They injured Nityananda Prabhu and they were very offensive and aggressive. So Mahaprabhu was called out his Sudarshan Chakra, right? He's ready to cut some necks. But Nityananda stopped him. No, this Leela, it's not happening. feeding everyone in a different way.
Shiranga kechaila kaveriya tira. Shiranga dekiya prime hoila hastira.
When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to the land of Shiranga Kshetra on the bank of the Kaveri. So this is one of the sacred rivers in India, right? Kaveri. It's included in this prayer, right? We are invoking holy water. Gange cha, Jamuna cheva, Godavari, Saraswati. Narmade, Sindhu, Kaveri, right? This is one of those holds. He visited the temple of Sri Ranganath and was there overwhelmed in the ecstasy of love of Godhead.
Chimalvate gore, koile prabhuvas, tahirohila prabhuvaisha chadimas.
Mahaprabhu lived at the house of Chimalvata for the 4 months of the rainy season.
Chivaishnav Chimalbhatta Parama Pandit Kosaye Panditya Premehoila Vishmit.
Sri Chimalbhatta was both a member. Oh, so this is actually the father of Raghunath Bhatta Goswami. So he was a member of the Vaishri, the Sri Vaishnava. So this is one of the four principal Vaishnava sampradayas. And Sri is a name for Lakshmi Devi. And so it is her lineage. So he was a member of the Sri Vaishnava community and a learned scholar. And there are also Brahmins, right? Bhatta. Therefore, when he saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who was both a great scholar and a great devotee of the Lord, he was very much astonished.
Chatramasyata Prabhu Shivaishnavera Sane Koilo Nitya Dita Krishna Sankirtane.
Mahaprabhu passed the Chaturmasya months with the Sri Vaishnavas, singing, chanting the holy name and dancing.
Chatramasyante Puna Dakingaman Paramananda Purisatai Milan.
After the end of Chaturmasya, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu continued traveling throughout South India. At that time, he met Paramananda Puri.
Tobe Bhatta Dadi Koite Krishna Dase Uda Nam Japi Vipramukhe Krishna Nam Prachar.
That's it. This is what I was trying to remember the other day, a few days ago. Kaliya Krishna. Kaliya Krishna Das. I don't remember if that was here or in London. I think it was in London. But he was a... After this, Krishna Das, the servant of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, was delivered from the clutches of a Bhatta Dadi. They're like a class of gypsies, these Bhatta Dadis. They live like a wild life. And, you know, I think they engage in some, you know, illegal activity, let's say. So what Mahaprabhu traveled to South India with his servant, and his servant got, there were some beautiful women in the group, and they, you know, enticed him, and they were holding him, keeping him in their group. And after this, Krishna Das, the servant of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, was delivered from the clutches of a Bhatta Dadi. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then preached. So Mahaprabhu, the point is, he went and like pulled them out. Is showing a very beautiful example. He didn't just, you know, let him, oh, he's run off. No, he went, there's this verse, you know, thing like, when this is described later in Chaitanya-charitamrita, there's this very nice verse. Gurudev would quote that verse, saying that, you know, glorious is the master, right? If his servant becomes lost or runs off, the master will come and grab him by the hair. Sounds like that. Drag him back. We want that type of relationship with our guru, right? And the higher Vaishnavas. If we deviate, they'll come and pull us back by the hair. By whatever means possible, shake us out of it, bring us back to our senses. Gurudev is here.
Mm-hmm.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then preached that Lord Krishna's name should also be chanted by Brahmins who were accustomed to chanting Lord Ram's name.
Shiranga Purisa Tahai Milan Ramdas Vipra Koilo Dugi Mochan.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then met Shiranga Puri and mitigated all the sufferings of a Brahmin named Ramdas.
Tatvamani Saha Koilo Tatvamichar Apanakehin Buni Hoilo Tasamar.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also had a discussion with the Tattvavadi community, and the Tattvavadis felt themselves to be inferior Vaishnavas, by which is meant that they could understand ultimately that their conception was not as developed, you know, as Mahaprabhu's conception. Mahaprabhu kind of challenged them. Certain points of Siddhanta.
Ananta Purushottam Shri Janardhan Padmanabhasudev Koilo Darshan.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then visited the Vishnu temples of Ananta Dev, Purushottam, Shri Janardhan, Padmanabha, and Vasudev.
Tove Prabhu Koilo Sapta Talimachan Setu Vandesnan Rameshwar Darshan.
After that, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu delivered the celebrated Sapta Tal trees, which literally means seven trees. Took his bath at Setu Bandha Vameshwar and visited the temple of Lord Shiva known as Vameshwar. I think Tal means, trees. So they were actually like some great sages. There was a fight between Bali and Sugriva. These were the monkey warriors related to Hanuman. I don't quite understand who they were, but some important person. You hear sometimes it's like a curse.
Nala and Kuvera, and what are they called? Kuvera, and they were the sons of the god of the treasurer of the gods, right? What are their names? I can't remember. But they got cursed by the sage to remain in the bodies of trees, right? And you remember that, right? And then that's the Damodar, part of the Damodar Lila, right? Krishna, he comes and knocks down these trees and they're delivered.
Tahi karilo karma,
because it's a difficult birth, actually. Birth of the tree. They're very conscious, but they're remaining like immobile. So our Gurudev was always very kind to trees.
Tahi karilo karma.
At Rameshwar, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had a chance to read the Korma Purana, in which he discovered that the form of Sita, kidnapped by Ravan, was not that of the real Sita, but a mere shadow representation.
Shunya Prabhu Anandita Vailoman, Ramdas Viparkata Vailosmanan.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very glad to read about the false Sita. And he remembered his meeting with Ramdas Vipra, who was very sorry that Mother Sita had been kidnapped by Ravan.
Sehi puratan patra graha kare nilo, Ramdase dekaya dukkandailo.
Indeed, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu eagerly tore this page from the Korma Purana, although the book was very old. And he later showed it to Ramdas Vipra, whose unhappiness was mitigated.
So Mahaprabhu just tore it from his ancient scriptures, like a few thousand years old.
But it's so beautiful because he was so concerned because he'd met this Brahmin who was like heartbroken, like thinking, oh, Sita was touched by this wicked Ravan, right? He kidnapped her. And then Mahaprabhu found this scripture explaining it wasn't the real Sita, right? He couldn't touch the real Sita. He just tears it out of the book. That's where it went. And what are the two other books that he discovered there? You can say. You remember? When he was traveling in South India.
Rama Sanghita.
Yes. And the other one, you remember? It's by Bilva Mangal Thakur. Krishna Karnamrita. These two books. Rama Samhita Karnamrita Dui Punti Paya Dui Pushtaka Loya Ila Uttam Janiya. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also found two other books, namely the Rama Samhita and Krishna Karnamrita. Knowing these books to be excellent, he took them to present his devotees. And what was the name of the temple where he found these books? We have one devotee in Sokal. He always likes to remind us. Because he has the name of that temple. Adi. You remember? Adi Keshava.
Adi Keshava.
Adi Keshava. It's when Gurudev gave him that name, Adi Keshava.
Yeah.
And that's the name of the temple. It's a deity, Vishnu deity, I think. He discovered. Sometimes he'll even like, if I post a Brahma Samhita class on Facebook, and he'll put in the comments, you know, what was the name of the temple? He always likes to remind us.
No, never forget.
Yeah, you can never forget. Punarapi nila chole gaman garilo bhakta gane meliya snanya chadekilo. After collecting these books, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu returned to Jagannath Puri. At that time, the bathing ceremony of Jagannath was taking place, and he saw it. Let me see. It would be nice to finish this chapter, but maybe we can. I think it might be too long. Anavasare Jagannath Napaya Darshan Virahaya Lalanath Kurila Gaman. When Jagannath was absent from the temple, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who could not see him, felt separation and left Jagannath Puri to go to a place known as Lalanath. So there's this Leela, this is part of the Leela of Jagannath, right? That there's this special bathing that takes place. And then he becomes sick. This is his Leela. For like, is it like a few weeks? I think it says here. 2 weeks. 15 days. So then no one can see him. Right? You cannot have his darshan. So Mahaprabhu is very sad. He cannot have the darshan of Jagannath. And so he goes to the next town. It's a funny thing, isn't it? Because like being in the same place, like you'd rather be somewhere else and not see him. You'd rather be somewhere than to be in the same place where you normally, because that's like more painful, right?
Right, right. You're so close.
Yeah, so far. Yeah, and you're being reminded all the time, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he just goes to the next town, like he can't bear it. And it's known as Anavasade, this period. And they can't see. It literally means something like that, like you can't be seen. Something like that. Bhakta sanedin koto tahe rohila
Kode bhaktai se samachar paila.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu remained for some days at Alalana. In the meantime, he received news that all the devotees from Bengal were coming to Jagannath Puri. So the Rath Yatra period is approaching, right? So the devotees from Bengal, they're coming.
Nityananda sarvabhauma graha kariya, nila chole aila mahaprabhu ke loya.
When the devotees from Bengal arrived at Jagannath Puri, both Nityananda Prabhu and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya greatly endeavored to take Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu back to Jagannath Puri. So they're all waiting in Puri, and Mahaprabhu is in the next town.
Virahe vival Prabhu na jane rachi dine, eno kale aile gune ra bhakta gane.
When Mahaprabhu finally left Alalana to return to Jagannath Puri, he was overwhelmed both day and night due to separation from Jagannath. His lamentation knew no bounds. During this time, all the devotees from different parts of Bengal, and especially from Navadvip, arrived in Jagannath Puri.
Sove mili jukti kore kirtana rambilo, kirtana vesha prabhur manstira hoilo.
After due consideration, all the devotees began chanting the holy name congregationally. Lord Chaitanya's mind was thus pacified by the ecstasy of the chanting. I think it's a good place to stop. And we'll hear more about some of the different devotees arriving. Okay. Jai Sri Chaitanya-charitamrita ki jai.